training, tactics, and calculation is one of the fastest way to improve in chess. So let's just do this now. And before we start calculating, let's start with the first thing you need to do. And this is evaluating the position. So first, take a look at the material. Then you will see the only difference in material is the distribution, because white has a bishop and black has a knight. The amount of pawns is the same, amount of rooks is the same, and queens also. So next step, let's compare the kings. And this is more interesting because the white king on g1 is rather safe. Well, the f-pawn is missing on f2, but it doesn't look too bad for white. I don't see a way for black to threaten anything here. Now let's take a look at the black king. The black king looks somehow badly placed. There might be some back rank issues. So now we have covered the king's safety and the material. Next step, attacked pieces. So this knight is attacking this pawn. These pawns are attacked, but this is nothing too significant because the queen of white on c4 attacks the a6 rook, and the rook on d1 is also attacking the knight on d4. And as said, the back rank is also weak. Another idea is the seventh rank. And let's start with an idea of occupying the seventh rank. Pardon me. So rook takes d4 is a very normal candidate move because it's taking something. So this is one of the first moves we should consider. Then the pawn takes, and now queen to f7, threatening back rank mate. Because after rook e8 check, rook takes e8, queen takes e8, the king cannot escape its mate. However, black has a defense here. Queen to d8, but the variation continues. If you want to increase the pressure against g7 and threaten mate, then you run into queen to g8, and white is actually down material and is very likely to lose this position. So this cannot be the solution. So what can be an alternative? Well, if you take a look at two factors, namely the back rank and this weakly protected rook, then you might realize that there is something very concrete. It's a takes b4, and this move forced the resignation of black. But why? Let's see what happens after queen takes b4. Well, this is pretty obvious. The queenside changed, and then follows the back rank mate. So this is not working. But where to put the queen? Because the queen has the very important task of defending the rook on a6. So rook to queen to b5, same idea, just exchange, and again it's mate. So this is also not working. And as you can see, there is just no alternative, and the most logical move would be just to retreat the queen. And then the rook is lost, and white is actually a piece up, but also has two connected passed pawns and is completely winning. If you want to see a very instructive video with another puzzle, then click on this link.